I just see motion.
Have you seen this?
This is special right here. This is special.
Oh! You filming now?
Yeah. Put the kettle on.
Where are we?
Good question, Joe. We're in my little homemade studio.
And why are we here? What are we doing?
This is a track by track for the people who like Segways or the people who don't like Segways. We're going to convert the people who don't like Segways.
Through a track by track.
Through an awesome track by track. It's essentially about unrequited love from an outside perspective. Me looking in to a friend's misfortune. I knew that the girl wasn't interested. She knew she wasn't interested, but he didn't know she wasn't interested. It's all about that night where I witnessed a desperate man being broken down. And, you know, I think it's something that everyone sees and goes through. And it's an interesting subject, and I enjoy looking in and not necessarily being the the point of ridicule. And it involves the same codes as Young Chasers. Don't tell anyone. But it sounds cool, so why not use it again, right?
If it worked once.
It's going to work twice.
Yeah.
So next album is just going to be based on that. Well, My Love was one of those tracks that I was in a band before Circa Waves, and which was amazing and I loved it, but it didn't feel like we were getting anywhere, which was really frustrating, obviously. So I sort of wrote the song about the idea of having to give all that up and, you know, get a real job, which is, you know, I didn't want to do. It's about giving up what you adore and what you want for something else. So yeah, it's probably the most emotional moment on the record, I'd say. It was quite this sort of huge, grand sounding song, very epic. And in Segways tradition, we tried to make it seem like it was, you know, recorded in someone's garage. This is the, this is a little insight, yeah? Don't read that, that's new. Ignore this. I'll be there's good for me. I'll be so bold to say you're the only one I've ever really known. It's exciting, isn't it? Swear to God I'm not the same as I was the other week. Yeah. Got a load of these at home, but this is the one I've used for Segways mainly, so.
Should we maybe talk about another song?
All right, Joe.
Or do you want to keep showing me stuff from your house like a toddler?
That's... Plays player of the season, runner-up. Is there anything more sad than being a player's player runner-up? You're our best friend. Not really. Started off a bit more grungy, like sort of... which is alright, but it's just not as good as what it turned out to be. We were listening to a lot of Mac DeMarco at the time, and he does this cool bendy thing with the guitar where it's not easy with an acoustic, but... Probably shouldn't do that to this guitar, but... In the first line there. I swear to God I'm not the same as I was the other week. I got you stuck in my teeth. Once I've written that, I could then go, okay, this is going to be good. That's how I tend to work, is I go, if the open line is good, then I can sort of write the rest of the song quite quick then. Whereas some songs I've just got the chorus and then I struggle to write and it takes me ages. You know, live, it's an amazing moment when we get to that point of... I'm a little too young, and everyone sings it. And to hear like 900 people in London singing that was one of the finest moments of my life. I don't know about you, Joe. So Young Chasers, name of the album and a single. Young Chasers was sort of based around that part of your youth, adolescence-y time when you just want something but you're not quite sure what, and like you yearn to figure some sort of meaning in your life, I suppose. It was the first time I made something really sort of simple and melodic and short, all confined into this neat little package. Once I recorded that, demoed it, I was I was pretty sure that was the sound I was after. Put it out into the world of the internet and saying low, played it, which sort of meant I had to get a band together and give you a call. Alicia Weathers about that sort of false nostalgia, the grass always being greener, essentially, when you're, you know, when you're looking back. Stuff like getting in a really hot car and the seatbelt burning your fingers was for some reason quite a strong memory for me. We were on tour in through Germany with the Libertines, yeah, as you remember, and I was on the bus playing the chorus and all that, and you said, oh, that's good. So we then went down to London and recorded it with our mate Dan Greck, and it sounds like the single that you hear today. That concludes our track by track with Sick Waves. See you next time.